existence.
Dictated by the memory of war,
Holocaust,
gulag,
occupation,
dictatorship, fascist in Western Europe, communist in Eastern Europe.
It takes tremendous existential drive.
To war.
The European problem.
Not so in Britain, which didn't experience occupation or defeat.
The British approach has always been much more economic and much more transactional.
And that helps explain why, when things didn't seem to be going so well in continental Europe, the urge to get out came stronger.
Moreover, even while we have been a member of the European Union, British leaders have almost never made the positive case.
Lincoln Crosby, the campaign strategist for David Cameron, had the line, "You can't fatten a pig on market day." And it's a good line. And basically what David Cameron tried to do was to fatten his pig on market day. And even Tony Blair, who was really the most pro-European of our prime ministers, along with Gordon Brown, actually, and of course Ken Heath, didn't give many pro-European speeches in Britain. Now, this leads me to another very important factor, which is one woman, Margaret Thatcher. Margaret Thatcher is by far the most influential British politician since Winston Churchill. And she became, in her latter years, a decided Eurosceptic with a very strong Our Island story view of history. In her book, Statecraft, she writes, I quote, "Most of the problems the world has faced have, in one fashion or another, come from mainland Europe, and most of the solutions from outside it.